25 out of the Rose 40 studies for clarinet. And I want to talk about three things quickly related to this etude. First off, the whole first half of this is one long, long tone. And what do I mean by that? I mean that you take a breath and you play a consistent, supported air stream. Let me show you what I mean without tonguing, okay? Just really nice flowing air. Then, all you have to do is touch your tongue to the reed lightly, not hard, to get that articulation sound that you want. Now, what you don't want to do is close the reed off so that your airstream gets kind of caught up in your throat and your lungs and the back of your mouth. What that does is it just chops your airstream up and it makes it much harder to support it. And it also kind of screws with the rhythm a little bit. Instead, think nice, smooth. Take a nice deep breath and blow. That's it. Okay. Then you want to take the same idea and bring it to the second half. Now, the second half is where you have to start articulating. But again, you want to touch the reed as lightly as possible so as to not cut off your airstream, okay? So take a deep breath and support. And in the beginning, it says piano, but don't worry about playing quietly yet. What you want to do is worry about playing with a nice, smooth airstream and getting the notes out. Now that's the other part of it. Getting the notes out is kind of hard. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn sideways and I'm gonna show you what you can do. I call it the head tilt. And the way it works, it's actually pretty easy to remember. You tilt your head up when you're going for high notes and down when you're going for low notes. And in the middle, it's kind of in the middle. So here's what I mean. So I'm going from the upper register D to an F. That's a sixth. It's a pretty big jump. So what that does is sort of, from a physics sense, your lip is a fulcrum, and what it does is it changes the angle of attack, if you will, on the reed. And simply, when you're going up, your mouth is going like that. This is your lip going like that, which means just a little more of the reed is vibrating. Why does that help? I don't know, but it does. So you lift your head up when you're thinking high, and you bring it down when you're going low. And when you're going really low, you're going to go even further. That will help you from squeaking, and it'll allow you, along with voicing, and you're going to have to practice voicing, it'll allow you to be able to get those notes out without grunting or squeaking. Third and last thing I want to talk about is what finger I would like you to use when you are playing the first half of this. Okay, so I'm going to go to measure 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in this etude. I want you to use your right hand to play these notes down here. Why? Because most of this happens in this hand and you don't have to coordinate when you do it that way. That means that your notes come out more smoothly. Here's what can happen if you don't do it that way. I'll play at that same place. So you get to play sometimes notes in between because you're coordinating this finger and this finger, da 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 da. It's a lot easier if you just take this hand out of the equation and just do it all in this hand. Practice that. You'll find it may feel a little bit weird because you're not used to doing it, but ultimately it's going to give you a lot more facility in your finger technique. Okay? Thanks for watching. See you next time.